In this lab session, I'm going to discuss a real-time project, that is deployment of an application on a Kubernetes cluster using Jenkins CI/CD. So that's a very important project. And to accomplish this project, we need three servers. The first one is for the Jenkins server, second one is for the Ansible server, and the third server I need for my Kubernetes cluster. And here the environment I'm going to use is the AWS environment. An operating system, I'm going to use the latest version of Ubuntu. So let's start. So first of all, I'm going to configure two Ubuntu servers on the AWS environment, and that is for the Jenkins server and Ansible server. And then we'll do the necessary software installation. And in the upcoming lecture, I'm going to configure my Kubernetes server. So let's start. So click on this launch instance. Name, I'm just giving Jenkins server, Ubuntu operating system. I'm okay with the latest one. Instance type for Jenkins and for Ansible, I can go with the t2.micro, but for your Kubernetes server, I need t2.medium. Key pair, I do have my existing key pair, so let me go with the existing one. And the number of instances, I want 2. Launch instance. So this is my Jenkins server. So let me rename. One is my Jenkins, another one is my Ansible. Perfect. So let me first log into my Jenkins server. So this is the IP. And to access the server, I'm going to use the Mobile XTEM software. Click on this session, SSH. This is the IP. Specify user, Ubuntu. Click on this advanced SSH setting. And here you have to provide the location of your private key. Click on OK, accept. Let me rename the tab. Right click, rename tab. So this is my Jenkins server. Okay, let me increase the font size as well. Perfect. Now we have to do the installation of Jenkins package. So let me go to the official site. And here just type Jenkins installation on Ubuntu. And click on this official site. And here we have all the flavors of Linux. So my operating system is Ubuntu. Click on it. And here we have two type of support release, long term and weekly release. So let me go with the weekly release. And before starting the installation of Jenkins, let me first install the Java. So here we have the commands for the installation of Java. Copy and paste. Java has been installed. Let me check the version. Perfect. Now coming back to my this site, scroll up. And here we have the steps for the installation of Jenkins. So first, let me copy these repositories. Copy and paste. And then you have to update the system. And finally, you have to install the Jenkins. Now Jenkins has been installed successfully on this system. Now let me check its service. Systemctl status Jenkins. Perfect. Now after the installation of Jenkins server, you can access your Jenkins server via the URL. So here, the Jenkins server works on port number 8080. So here you have to keep in mind this port. Perfect. So we need to first allow this port from the security group. So coming back to my this AWS environment and click on this security. So this is the default security which has been assigned to my this system. And click on this edit inbound rules. So as of now, I'm allowing all the traffic. Save. And let's see the IP. This is the IP of my Jenkins server. So to access, you have to provide the public IP :8080. Perfect. Now here you have to provide the password, and to get the encrypted password, you have to get this file into your server. So this is the password. Administrator password. Click on continue. Go with the install suggested plugins. Here it will take 10 to 15 minutes. So just wait for some time. Now this is the next page. Here you have to create the first admin user. So I'm giving my name Shikhar. The password is also I'm giving Shikhar. You can take according to your requirement. And then click on save and continue. So this is the URL which can be used to access your Jenkins server. Save and finish. And this is the dashboard of your Jenkins server. So friend, that's all for this lecture. In the next lecture, we'll discuss about how we can configure the plugins which is required to start communicating between your Jenkins server to the Ansible server. So that's all. We'll see you in the next lecture.